Hey guys, it's Sasuke here, and welcome back to Nuclear Throne. Man, I love this game! Every time I get ready to play it, I'm so excited. Like, you don't even know, man. It's crazy. So, it looks like we get the Weekly Horror B-Skin with just basic. We a basic bitch. So, a lot of people like taking the Weeklies as, like, a, they'll do, like, a run to check it out to see what kind of stuff you get, then they'll do another run to actually, like, legitimately run it. I'm not really into that too much. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'd love to be in, like, the top 100 for the daily or the weekly, but I'm not really caring too much to go over and do it over and over. I did that once with the, what was it? I think we did melting or something? I did that once with a melting daily. And it was fun. Like, I enjoyed trying to progress further and knowing what was coming up so you could plan your next move accordingly. But, I don't know, that's not what Nuclear Throne is about to me. It's always been about, like, the craziness, the over-the-top shenanigans that happen. And when it's all plotted out and planned out so perfectly and you can do it over and over, it kind of takes away from that for me. I guess I didn't like it too much. Okay, this is pretty scary, actually. We're gonna push out. I'm so happy we didn't run into that bullet. I would have felt real dumb. Go ahead and pick this up. I'm gonna push in here, but, like, kind of carefully. Mostly because that boss is, like, on our tail. Double screwdriver? Man, they must be trying to tell me something. Actually, I get the feeling they are trying to tell me something with that many screwdrivers dropping. So I'm just gonna say maybe there's some logic to it, and I'm gonna take one with me. Let's go ahead and pick up that early impact wrist. I love it. I love it, love it, love it. On these close range areas, like the sewers, you never know how much help it's gonna be. The nice thing about it that a lot of people don't even think about is even if it does one hit of damage by colliding with somebody, that's one less HP that guy has. So he takes one less bull to kill. He takes one less whatever to kill. It's nice. I would not recommend taking out your screwdriver and smacking a rat in the face. I mean, I'm just saying, that's not something that I do often, but when it happens, boy do I feel manly. Okay, we got a pop rifle to come down with us. Not really ideal, but it's something. Let's go ahead and take a strong spirit. I was about to go, who am I thinking of? I was about to go full sleep cycles on you there for a second. Let's go strong spirit. I almost freaking win him. And I was like, no, not like this. It's probably offensive, and I don't want to offend the guy. He's freaking amazing. I love watching that guy's content. It's real good. So there was an explosion up here. Oh, it looks like you couldn't have gone because the thing blew up instantly. But we went a little bit further and found the screwdriver, or the laser weapon, which is literally like a million times better in every way possible. Not only because they're broken right now with the double damage, but also, like, even without the double damage, it's probably gonna be better. Looks like you aren't allowed to get crowns, which I'm fine with. I'd rather do a crownless run anyway. Crown of Blood can be fun if you have the right setup, but I'm not personally good enough to really put up the crazy good records like a lot of people are. So if anything, this is one of the few things that brings me on an even playing ground with everybody else, is not being able to do those crowns. Which is unfair to them, but it's fair. It's crap to me, so I'm okay with it. Okay, we're almost level 5. Our weapons are pretty damn good. Big dog should be guaranteed. Unless we really F it up. So, big dog is awake. I'm gonna take this a little bit slower than I normally would, I think. Big dog's down, sniper died behind him. We are level 5, and there's a bullet weapon here. Interesting. So here's the choice. Second stomach is what we're gonna go with. I love second stomach, and I've only grown to respect it more and more throughout the time I've used it. Oh! Strong spirit, thank you. We got a little bit of HP back. So yeah, not only do we do like double damage with these lasers, but the crystals also do double damage, if you are not aware. We're back up to 7 HP, which is great. I'd love to get a strong spirit back. Alright, we got a little bit of energy too. That was so scary. If we would have died there, I would have felt so disappointed. Oh, whoa, whoa, calm down. We're live though, we're level 6, we're heading into the next area. Probably Rhino Scan, but I kinda want Scarier Face too. Cause if we could get Scarier Face with Scarier Face with Laser Brain, like our damage would just go up like 1000%. And that would be hella nice. Seriously, we would deal so much damage. Yeah, that was a lot of people. Let's go ahead and take care of them. Good stuff, getting lots of ammo, surprisingly. To not have a rabbit's paw, we're getting so much ammo. That grenade shotgun's actually tempting, because I have been using the grenade weapons more often. Not only, obviously, the grenade launcher, but like the grenade shotgun, the grenade, the auto grenade rifle or whatever. I've been using those a lot more to great degrees of success. I don't know. If it keeps going the way it's going right now, I have a pretty damn good feeling about Little Hunter. As long as we don't F it up pretty bad here, pretty sure Little Hunter should be easy. Just because we're Horror, and Horror has a really good time against bosses where as it is. Especially with Little Hunter. Because your right click pretty much mitigates like 90% of his scariness. The only part it doesn't really mitigate is him summoning a butt ton of IDPD. And you can kind of mitigate that with your positioning around him. So, if that's Super Crossbow, auto. Yeah, okay. Can we hit that? There we go. Just kind of happy. Oh, I know it! I should have just right-clicked. That was a very, very big mistake. Well, I mean, it's not the biggest mistake in the world, but it's definitely annoying. So, homing bolts would have been nice. Trigger fingers is what we're going to go with. If we found a heavy weapon or something, I would definitely be all about it. We're just going to clear this area out of dogs, mostly. Okay, here he is. There we go, we're already burning them. Nice, he's dead. I went ahead and used like all of our XP. I don't think it's a mistake. I definitely think it's a good idea to do so. If you ever feel threatened on Horror, don't be afraid to use your experience. You can always get more experience while you live. I mean, obviously that doesn't mean go out and use every single bit that you have. But at the same time, it means don't be scared of using it. What came down with this? Was it a bolt weapon or an energy weapon? I think it was energy. No, it's neither. Alright, quit playing hard to get. Got some HP. Got a free kill. More free kills. I'm happy when those things show up. Oh! There went all our HP. Alright, Bloodlust. We want this HP, but we better not suicide for it, so. Nice, we're back up to full. We don't have strong spirit though, so if this plant guy decides to explode on us, we're dead. So we're gonna advance carefully. Nicely done. That was so frightening. So, the oh, come on. The impact wrist is so fantastic here. Double shotgun, not tempting. I was about to say tempting, but it's really not. Now this is probably the scariest part of our journey, other than the throne itself, of course. Oh, come on. I hate when they do that when they're really close to you. You never expect it, and you always take a lot of damage from it. Ooh. Things we need. 100%, we need Hyper Launcher. It's something we need. Without the mutation to make that weapon better, the auto... See, I don't know. A lot of the really, really high-level players use auto crossbows up into the second loop. But I don't like them. I know a lot of them choose Bolt Marrow, which is something I didn't have. Oh, yes. Maybe we can get our HP back here. Okay, we have our HP back. Feel a little safer. There we go. Those are some good kills. Those are some really good kills. Ooh, that's the end. Energy. Bolts. XP. I was hoping for ammo, but we're gonna get max ammo on the throne fight anyway. So I think we mainly use the hyper launcher. Oh, trying to tempt me. really tempting, actually. Like, I think I'm gonna take it tempting. After this fight, I want to use the hyper launcher for the generators, and then we're gonna use mainly the energy weapon on our adventure against Throne 2, probably, and mostly Throne 1. We'll see how far the hyper rifle or the hyper launcher actually goes. We have quite a bit of XP too, if things get too scary. Now that was a bit of a mistake. Alright, so let's not be afraid of using the hyper launcher. I think it's probably the best and smartest idea. Alright, he's dead. Great stuff. I'm just gonna let this ammo come to us, and then we're gonna hold back so these weapons come with us too. Then we're gonna keep the energy weapon for now and price swap for the energy sword for the loop. So, oh yeah, there's rain. Nice stuff. Now we have our he's dead. Fantastic. Energy weapon came with us. Our energy sword, rather. We might take it. I don't know. I'm still on the fence about it at this point. Just because what we have is working so well. Those two elite IDPD coming out right there, I bet that killed more people than you'd imagine. So the hyper launcher is going to be godlike for us. I think we're going to keep the if we had the ability to withstand explosions, I think we would freely give our weapon away for the melee. But since we don't, I think we're going to have to keep it, just in case something gets in our face and we can't handle it with the other weapon. I'd rather have this, because like, they can be at medium range and you don't want to shoot. It's too scary that you might kill yourself pretty much. I don't know what even hit us there. We level ultra though. This is really good for us. Oh, that was bad damage then. Oh, I did not know if that was the end. Definitely gonna go anomaly, it's probably my favorite mutation. A lot of people don't agree. A lot of people don't like Anomaly that much. I, however, am a big fan of it. Oh, he hit me with one. Alright, he's down, so let's calm it back down. We got most of the scary stuff out of the way, so we can kind of focus on the less important craft of life at the moment. Nice, that's the end. Everybody instantly explodes when they think about walking into my house! And they're all dead. Let's go. Good stuff. Ammo generation is decent. Hyper slugger is scary, or hyper launcher is scary, because we could just kill ourselves with it, like, really easily. But we're pretty much hoping, like, that's just not the case. Your main enemy here is just going to be yourself. Let's go ahead and take care of these guys before they... Oh, do that. Damn, that hurt. Nice. Back up to a good HP level. And he's dead. Gonna wait for these shots to expire, then we're gonna head in there. Nicely done. What was that? Heavy grenade shotgun. Wait, was that... Did I really read that? Heavy grenade shotgun? I've never seen that one. Did not see that coming. Not know we got hit by something. Nicely done. Good stuff. Stay cool, calm, and collected, and we'll be getting out of here anytime. You gotta be careful that those don't explode on you. because of the anomaly portal. It happens a lot. Got a little bit of shells and some for the energy, honestly. Okay. Good infiltration there. Oh, I didn't even see that guy until he hit me. Is that everybody? That is. Nicely done. Get all the goodies, nom nom, and let's leave. So I think if we find Big Dog early, we're just gonna instantly burst him down. Yep, there we go. I just went, I'm going in for the kill. I do it for the thrill, blah blah blah. I'm hoping you understand. And let's leave. This is kind of scary. This is where I die a lot. I die more often than not here. There's a crystal shooting at us. We've already pissed off the Ivor Crystal, but I don't know where it is. I'll tell you, I'd love to make the van come. Ooh, that's a buff gator. Yeah, that's pretty much what I was hoping for. Nice. Got a decent amount of energy back. I still want more, though. I need it. That's good. It's gonna be scary to use the grenade weapon here. More than anywhere else, it's gonna be scary here. But as long as we play it like at a distance, I think we're gonna be fine. Always take out the IDP that spawned behind you before you worry about the stuff in front of you. It sounds obvious, but you'd be surprised how many people kinda let them, like, they're like, oh, I'll just push forward and then leave them behind them, and then it becomes a massive problem for them later. Alright, we're doing good on energy, got good shells. I don't know why we care about that, but we have them. It's a good thing, I suppose. And don't forget, we still have a right click. I haven't really found a situation to even use it right now. But we still have that ability if we need. Kind of like shooting at like the very end of the screen here. Oh, wow. I did not know that was the end. Happy though. Okay, little hunter, watch out for him. Oh my god, this is the perfect place to fight him. We just need to find out where he's gonna drop. Oh, right here. Aww, he blew up on me. We're at no HP now. Scary. There's a lot of people down there. Oh, man. Oh, he died. Nice. Anomaly! It's an anomaly at how we're alive, if that's what I'm saying. Alright, we're on to one of my least favorite areas. You can easily run out of ammo here from over-spamming, so... Oh, God. Ultra laser pistol over what we have? I don't know. We're gonna use a lot of our XP here, so we can save some of our ammo on the individual shots. Now we're gonna push in and find this before they have a really good chance to set up in here. Alright, don't forget. Don't forget to right-click. Right-clicking is extremely important. Okay, we just need to go find this last guy. Nice. Oh! God, these dark areas are the scariest, man. I don't know where it is. Oh, it wasn't even here. Nice. We live. A little nervous about our ammo, though. Need to make sure these doggies don't jump on us. It's the only thing we're really worried about right now. No, jungle shotgunner is what killed me last time I got here on the first loot. That was bad. Oh no! We did it! We effed ourselves! Oh man, that was a really good run though! Damn leaderboard. Do we want to do the... What if it's a long episode? You know what, we'll just do it. If it's a long episode, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to go out of the way to kill myself for it. We got the daily, we got Chicken. Chicken's right-click ability is to throw her weapon, which I will demonstrate. Sha. And Sha. It's something. I think not a lot of the Nuclear Throne community would disagree that Chicken has one of the more interesting right clicks, but probably one of the least used, if I had to guess. Not because it's not good, necessarily. It does a lot of damage. The problem is it's scary to use. Like, you could lose your weapon by throwing it. So we're gonna go ahead and pick up the early laser pistol. I'm so sad that we lost that run, man. We could have looped twice and beyond with that easily. Like, if we would have got to the throne fight, guaranteed win. I didn't know where the car was coming though. That was the main problem there. Then I thought we were gonna kill it one shot earlier than we did, so it just blew up right in our face. Went ahead and picked up our strong spirit, as a famous man of sleep cycles would say. Love that guy. I really want to take care of this guy, but I think we're gonna push forward a little bit and then push into here so he can't see us, and then we're gonna push out with the assault rifle. I know he's to our north. I don't know where. He went to our sneaky hole that we were in. Go ahead and pick up some more energy. And he's done. Good night, sweet prince. We don't need to throw any weapons into the portal right now. These weapons are literally good enough to carry us for probably to the ice caves is when we want to, would, you know, this the latest I would recommend, at least, carrying an assault rifle. Any time past that with the assault rifle is time that, you know, it's not time well spent. That's pretty much what we're trying to say here. I'm so sad about that frickin' weekly, man. We could have been the ones. We could have been the showstoppers. The up-and-coming, the Legion that no one's ever heard about. But we didn't have, and that's completely fine. Bazooka's tempting. We could go visit the Turtle Bros. Get some pizza. Who doesn't love pizza? Just chuck a weapon at that guy. Throw a weapon at this guy. The throne butt for Chicken is that weapons pierce when you throw them, so it's specific to her. For you throwing weapons is. I thought we threw both of our weapons and they didn't hit the guy. That's about to be sad. Hey, let's go ahead and leave. We are level 4. Back muscle. I think I'm going to go Plutonium Hunger. A lot of people have lost respect for Plutonium Hunger because it got nerfed a couple times. I'm not in that boat necessarily. I still think it's just as good as it ever was. Well, that's a lie. Obviously, if you get nerfed, you're never going to be as good as you were. That is, like, literally the definition of a nerf, right? At the same point in time, I think it's perfectly fine. I mean, I've never picked it up and been disappointed with it. Every time I need ammo and the ammo's far away, boom, it's being dragged to me. I want weapons, weapons don't. But ammo and HP from far away, they're dragged to me. Like, it's just good. I'm not gonna say ignorant, because that's pretty rude. But I would go as far as to say, like, maybe a little ill-conceived. Like, maybe you've had a time or two of bad runs where you felt like you deserved ammo that was further away or something and it just didn't come to you. That's me projecting. I don't know if that's what's happened in your life or not. and pick that up. I'm happy these cars didn't explode on us. So as this not being weekly, we could, if we wanted, get a crown. Yeah, I knew there'd be something up here. Honestly, it's just, it's quiet. Too quiet. Now, I don't know, we could go for the infinite throwing thing like we did last time, but we didn't really use it. Like, I tried it, I didn't like it. I felt like I was forcing myself to get over and use it. Whereas, like, a right-click, you want it to be pretty natural. Like, I kind of just charged through those bullets because I knew we were about to get hit once, so I knew we'd get a small freeze frame of vulnerability if we charged through. But yeah, you want a right-click to be somewhat, like, natural. Like, when you right-click as a plant or... Ooh. Yeah. When you right-click as plant or you right-click as crystal or something, like... Or even fish, like, you know exactly what you're gonna do and how well it's gonna work. And all those good, the good information that you need to know to be an informed right-clicker. That was a bit of dumb damage, but I thought he was gonna die, but it hit the crystal in front of him. But yeah, when you right-click as, like, chicken, you really don't. Like, sometimes your weapon, if, I think one thing that they should do, that would be the ultimate cool thing for chicken ever, and would probably make her my favorite character. I don't even know what hit us. I guess some residual laser shot or something hit us. But what would make her cool? That would literally probably bring her to my favorite character in the game. If when you picked up Impact Wrist, if it covered your weapons. Imagine this, right? You pick up Impact Wrist, you throw your weapon, and your weapon starts bouncing everywhere. Like crazy, insane bouncing everywhere. And then when you have your level 10, it automatically returns to your secondary slot. That sounds amazing! I mean, I don't know. That just sounds like so good to me. I think I want to mutate later. I mean, back muscle was probably the only thing I would think about there. But there's so much more that I want, aka Rabbit's Paw mostly, is what I'm looking for. Rabbit's Paw, Laser Brain, stuff like that. The stuff I almost consider essential at this point to a good run. I say almost because I've had good runs without, you know, a couple mutations here and there. But the good majority of the time, it's things that you want because they are just solid. Nicely done. Impact Wrist is also something I want. Energy Hammer is not something I'm really interested in. If we didn't have our weapon set up as we did right now, I might go for it. But, nice, we got our bolts. I was kind of scared that they would break off and both be energy. That happens a lot. Pretty obvious here, probably second stomach. I really like Eagle Eyes with homing weapons. Do I like it more than Bloodlust? Let's try it. I think it's really good with homing weapons. So, is this little hunter territory? Or is that next level? I think that's next level. It's kind of scary that I don't remember, but I do think it's next level. Because we're next level, of course. Oh! It just seems like it's been two levels because we had, Patience? I think is what it's called. I don't know, my brain is literally... Oh! Don't throw that car. That blood hammer is calling to me. Oh, that's calling to me even more! Am I really about to do this, though? Man, I feel so bad for getting rid of the laser weapon. If we get laser rifle, we'll come back and reconsider our laser options. But I think Gatling Slugger is too good. The Gatling Slugger is too good to pass up. I don't know if it's controversial either. It's probably something that 99% of you would say yes. If we get a laser rifle, I'll take it. Laser cannon, laser minigun. I'd take all those variations of the weapon. But I think this is probably just the better idea overall. So we should probably just wait for the boss here. They decided to spawn in this area, which is interesting. Because we have homing weapons, I don't think he realized. Yeah, he didn't know we had homing weapons, and he cornered himself. Interesting choice. Let's go ahead and kill that guy with the car. I don't want to F with him. He scares me more than anything. Double flame shoddy, definitely not worth it. Take some more bolts, and that's the end. Nice. Already level 7. We're already going to the labs. I like it. I like it a lot. But yeah, I hope you guys can actually see, man. I've been playing a lot. I've been trying to get better. I want to put up runs that are interesting, right? Like, that horror run was pretty good. We almost made it to loop 2. It's a run that I was proud of. Not the way we died. The way we died kind of... The way we died kind of made me sad. But other than the way we died, I liked everything else about it. I really... Oh, I didn't shoot? I thought I shot. One thing I want... Want is maybe the not correct word. One thing I need is a better word. I need the ability to have either... Yep, that was what to say. Rabbit's Paw or stronger lasers. I need them. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. Without them, I'm probably not gonna go much further. Oh, I didn't even see him blow up. There we go. Look at all these drops we're getting. Such a good freaking mutation, man. Probably one of the best mutations, to be 100% honest with you. I don't know why I shot that. Literally like the freest walk into ever, but I was just like, I gotta shoot it! So, stronger lasers is absolutely what we are in need of right now. So, it actually came down with us, whatever it is. It's an energy weapon. Ooh, what are you? A lightning cannon. I don't think the lightning cannon is worth it. Maybe that's an ill-informed decision of mine. I'm not sure. I didn't see what hit us, but I can only assume it was one of the energy balls because the amount of damage it did. Oh! This is scary. Worked out though. We're almost level 9. Since we're not horror, I would love to level up. Nice. Is there really no way to hit 10 or 9? No. Damn. I kind of wish we didn't have this weapon. Bouncer shotgun's gonna be better for the fight. Just because the problem with the seeking weapons is they don't seek towards the generators. Like, even if you're right beside them, they're like, and we dodged, and they'll go straight for the throne. So that's not really what we want here. What I'm thinking is, laser cannon most of these down, if we can, and then switch over to our shotgun and just spam bullets down the hallway while running. And if he goes doot, 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 too close to us, we're just gonna switch back to the laser cannon and go ham. So now, oh, I timed it right. I love that. You get a little split second of an extra shot out if you time it correctly. Okay, it's going well. I was really aiming for the energy, not the bullets there, but that's fine. Okay. Projecting a little bit far there, are you? Oh, don't. He's dead. We're out of energy. Give me all this energy, please. You go! Okay, we got a lot of goodies back. I kind of wish we would have waited for our pistol. Ooh, it's fine. Hope we can find a better one, honestly. Like a seeker shotgun would be the dream. I did it too soon. I'm gonna use all of our energy here because we're just scared about surviving right now. Oh! That was bad damage. It's okay. It's the laser beams again. Oh, don't run me down! Please die. You gotta die. You got to die. There is no more life for you. Good day, sir! We almost hit ultra. I think we're gonna bleed out time because we didn't find throne, but if we did, there were better options. We need better weapons. Well, we need one better weapon. We need something to replace this bullet weapon, which we have no use for at the moment. I'm so sad that we don't have the ability to knock corpses around. It's gonna make this so much more difficult. As I say, I don't know where it's coming from, so I'm just gonna attend to my own matters up here first. took him down. I'm real sad we don't have the... Some of the stuff I consider essential most of the time. Don't have anything to make this laser weapon better, so we're in the market to replace the laser weapon. As good as it is. Flame cannon. Heavy machine gun is just like a literal upgrade, right? That's like a literal downgrade. Flame cannon, flame cannon, flame cannon, flame cannon. Over the laser cannon? The laser cannon is OP right now. We don't have trigger fingers. I can't decide yet, so we'll just throw it down there. I'm gonna use it a little bit in this next little area, and maybe it'll be good enough to help us. Determination, I don't like it. And I mean, we don't have the stuff for it anyway, like I said previously, so we're going harder to kill. Not the worst right now. I mean, I've definitely seen better weapons, but I've definitely seen a whole lot worse too, to be 100% honest with you. I knew it was gonna hit us. Where are these IDPDs spawning, man? They're spawning like miles out of the way. Oh, this is gonna be good. Oh, it hit us! Shit! No, yes! I thought he died! I thought he died, man! He had a death warrant and he lived! Alright, sorry, Flame Cannon. You're so cool, but you're so mediocre. I'm pretty sure it's just been nerfed a lot, because there was a time when every time I picked the weapon up, it was just like, whoa, 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 whoa. It wasn't like, whoa, 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 whoa. That's more like a rap song. It was more like, thanks for the free loot. But it seems to have lost a lot of its amazingness. The Blood Launcher. I like the Blood Launcher a lot. It's risky because you can just kill yourself with it. But let's just try it. I could have thrown the weapon. We committed. About time you committed to something. Oh, burn. No. But we finally committed. I'm a little nervous about the idea of it, but... We got our Sean Spear back, so we won't die in the one hit from this guy at least. Alright. He's down. Good stuff. One less thing to worry about. Well, I guess you would say technically two less things to worry about, huh? It's not godlike. It does blow up a lot of the shots though, which is pretty damn convenient. God, we need to replace these weapons. They're just not good enough. What came down to this? The bouncer SMG. That's exactly what I wanted, thank you. How did you know what we wanted for Christmas? At least we have the Bloodlust, I suppose. It is keeping us a little bit more healthy than we would be otherwise, I do suppose. There's so much we don't have right now, and yet we're making the run work, which actually makes me really happy. There's a lot of things that I almost consider mandatory that we don't own. And we're still making it work. Like, I can't believe we have a mutation that we just don't have a weapon for right now. It's like blowing my mind. It's like, it's a nightmare that it's blowing my mind too. So this is probably where we end our run, if I had to guess. Right now, this is pretty much the DPS check. If you can't kill Bullmom fast enough, she kind of Fs you pretty hard. Unlike a lot of bosses that you can kind of get through skill and dodging, Bullmom kind of just overwhelms you eventually with shit on the screen. Which, I mean, yeah, technically, yes, you could overwhelm it with dodging of an enormous caliber. We're gonna run all the way back up here. Pick up a weapon that at least has ammo in it. And she's advancing on us, I can hear her. So. Oh, that hit us, come on. Oh my god, you're not dead. So I'm keeping an eye on our ammo just so we don't end up killing ourselves. Because you can over spam and kill yourself with this easy. Because that's what the blood can does, is it starts to take HP if you're down too low. This is stupid as crap. Oh my god, he freaking like two-shotter. So good. These weapons are not good. We need something, man. Give me it. I'm trying to survive. I'm trying to live with what you give me. And this is a world I don't want to live in right now. Oh. Nicely done. Good shot. That was a big-ass explosion. We're getting just enough explosives to live right now. Got our HP back to full, got a little bit of ammo. Enough to survive. Oh god. Why are we stuck in this nightmare right now? Why couldn't we just have like gotten some godlike weapons and won? Like in the frickin' weekly. That that's what's happening. We F the weekly and now the game is punishing us for it. It's like, oh. You're gonna throw away such a beautiful run? Such a majestic creature can't be thrown away like that. What the hell was with that? Let's just fucking leave. I'm out. Goodbye. Crown of Blood is literally the ultimate saying, I'm gonna die. I know it. Shall we? Look forward onto dawn, because oblivion would be more beautiful than anything. Okay. It's a teleporting guy here. Oh. Oh, come on. We're dead. Good night. Pop up. Thank you. That's exactly what I wanted to have happen, yep. Just give me something. Blow up the car. Walk over here. Kill him. We're alive. Not for long. Oh my god, we walked through the bullets. The game just told us that we were Neo. Oh, come on. We got 6 HP. Ah! You gave us good weapons at the end, though. Oh, that hurt. One thing I'm not comfortable with is not having, we're dead. Like, we can't live. Unless there's a large HP chest somewhere. I mean, it doesn't hurt. You can't hurt me! Alright, that's actually two extremely good runs. I'm perfectly happy with both of them. You know, something I've noticed, every single time I do well, the daily scoreboard doesn't load. I die on the first floor, and it's like, look, you are 7 trillionth. You're a shitter. Shitters Incorporated. GG, boys. Anyway, that's going to do it for today's video, guys. If you guys liked it, a little 2-for-1, I'd greatly appreciate the likes. It lets me know you're enjoying the series and all that good stuff. If you did like it, consider commenting. I read and respond to every single one. Subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. Recommend it to anybody who may be interested. And I hope you guys have the most amazing day in the whole damn world. See you guys.